Honorable Chairman of the Council of Ministers of the Government of Nepal, Honorable Minister Priti Baba Pradhan, Government of Nepal, Honorable K.P. Sharma Oli, UML Leader, Honorable Chung Wee Yong, Co-Chairman of the Standing Committee and Secretary General of the ICAP, Honorable Malahat Ibrahim Kizi, Co-Chairperson of the ICAP Women's Wing, Member of Parliament and Member of the Political Council, Yeni Azerbaijan Party, Honorable Park In-soo, Co-Chairperson of the ICAP Women's Wing, Member of the National Assembly, Sai Nuri, New Frontier Party of Korea. Distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen, it is with great pleasure that I extend a very warm welcome to our distinguished guests and esteemed delegates from ICAP member states at this August gathering in this historic capital city of Nepal. I welcome the presence of the Right Honorable Mr. Kilraj Redmi, Chairman of the Council of Ministers, and respected colleagues from political parties of Nepal, which underpins the importance Nepal attaches to the conference. Human trafficking continues to persist as a modern form of slavery. It is an offense and constitutes a serious threat to the enjoyment of human rights and human dignity. The overwhelming number of trafficked victims has been women and children. These challenges has assumed an alarming proportion at national, regional, and international levels. It is distressing to see in many parts of the world, including our own region, that gender continues to shape one's role at home, society, and the economy in the 21st century. More so, birth of a girl child in a family often still stands as one of the most unfortunate things to happen. Girls remain powerless as they are largely excluded from opportunities that we consider as given. Let us never ever forget that gender disparities at young age have long-term impacts in national life and prove to be more costly to overcome later. It is encouraging to see the international development community recognizing gender equality and empowerment of women as one of the important and legitimate policy goals and its inclusion as in the Millennium Development Goals. Individual countries have recognized the gravity of the situation and come up with various mechanisms in developing and least developed countries. In the South Asian region, SAARC has adopted a convention on combating and prevention of trafficking in women and children for prostitution in 2002. Having duly recognized the grave consequences of gender differences and disparities, ICAP has been organizing a series of meetings since May 2008 on women's leadership and empowerment. These meetings have been a positive force at strengthening unity among Asian countries to bring the core issues to the fore and underlining the urgency to address the associated challenges in a comprehensive, coordinated, and consistent manner. Asia and the Pacific region have increasingly acquired global attention because of its dynamism amidst vast diversity. It is both an opportunity and challenges on all of us to manage the rich diversity and enrich the unique unity among Asian countries to address the unfolding challenges of all sorts before us. I am happy to report that the ICAP has also been trying to reach out to political parties in Latin America and the Caribbean and share experiences from the best practices to advance the cause of women empowerment. It has also started coordinating with political parties in Africa to establish a similar organization. We aim to bring together political parties regardless of their ideological orientations from Asia, Africa, and Latin America in 2014 and develop into a global institution. We hope that coming together of political parties from across the world would strengthen our quest for a more peaceful, equitable and prosperous world. Human trafficking is a global issue and therefore requires international coordination and cooperation to fight it. Several factors including gender disparities, economic inequality, lack of empowerment opportunities, absence of basic social services as well as other oppressive conditions especially affecting women and children create fertile nurseries leading to human trafficking. Tendency to imitate modern luxury lifestyle, glamour, basic aspirations among other make them vulnerable to trafficking. It is painful to note that fact that more than 50% of human trafficking happens in Asia and the Pacific. At the 4th World Conference on Women held in Beijing in September 1995, there was a commitment to advance the goals of equality, development and peace for all women everywhere in the interest of humanity. It is my firm belief that we can best work to realize these goals by unleashing energies of our youthful population and empowering them regardless of color or creed, ethnicity and economic status. We look forward to valuable contributions from the distinguished participants and make the workshop relevant to the victims of this heinous crime to give them a dignified life. With the words, I once again express warm words of welcome to the esteemed delegates and respected friends and wish all of you a pleasant stay in Nepal. At the end, I would also like to thank Turkish Cooperation and Coordination Agency, TICA, and Korean International Cooperation Agency, KOICA, for their valuable support. I wish the workshop a great success. Thank you. Thank all the delegates for making this workshop successful. And I also would like to thank Honorable Chun Hui Yong for coming all the way from Korea for this workshop and helping us. He is also General Secretary of ICAC, as you know. I would like to thank all the very important ladies sitting on the dais from China, Korea, Azerbaijan, and Turkey, co-chairpersons, everybody I want to thank, and also KOICA and Turkey Cooperation. Many, many thanks for their support and help. And something very small, I want to give message to our Nepali political parties.
Investment and government, so much. What is the value of the cash? I mean, the report.
जाने जाने ना हमरो ये फोरम मा हामी ए भएर युनाइटेड भएर एशियन फोरम केरु एउटै आवाजमा हामी अगाडि बढेर देखि हरेक समस्याको हामी समाधान गर्न सक्छौ र आज म तपाईहरुसित बिदा लिन्छु र वन्स अगेन आई लाइक टु थ्याङ्क एभ्रीबडी फर कमिंग एन्ड जॉइनिंग अस एन्ड in every problem we can only solve with peace and stability. I was just telling them, you know, that we have all resources in Asian countries. Only if we unite, look, China is here, Korea is here, all oil-rich country, one of the richest country of the world, largest investment, all countries are sitting here, and we can, in Nepal, if we have solve all our political problems, we can bring a lot of investment, we can bring gas, oil, all the resources we can share with each other and develop Asia. Thank you.